Good morning, children. Once again, welcome back to your Google Classroom. We discussed the first part of the story, the ashes that made trees bloom. Let's recall the main points which we have already discussed. In the good old days of the Daimyo, there lived an old couple with their pet dog. What was the name of the pet dog? Yes, Myuko. They had no child, so they loved the dog as their own son. They had a greedy and cruel neighbors. One day, the old man got a heap of gold with the help of the dog. They became rich. This made the cruel couple envious. They decided to try their luck. So, they dragged the dog out of the doors. Did they got the gold? No. Instead of the gold, they found a foul-smelling dead kitten. So they became very angry and killed the dog. Our poor, kind old man became very sad after hearing the death of the dog. He cried for a very long time. That night, the spirit of the dog appeared to him in his dream. The spirit of the dog asked him to cut down the pine tree over his grave. And it also informed him to make a mortar and a mill out of it. The old man did so. Then, with the mortar and mill, the old couple again got gold. The cruel and greedy couple borrowed the mortar and mill from them. This time, they found a foul mass of worms. So, they became very angry and they chopped off the mortar and mill into pieces to use as firewood. We discussed up to this. Let's discuss the second part of the story. After a few days, the generous old man dreamt again. This time, the spirit of the dog informed him about how the mill and mortar had been burnt. He then informed him to take the ashes of it and sprinkle them over the withered trees to make it bloom again. The old man reached to his neighbor's home. There, he found them sitting in front of the fireplace, burning the pieces of the mill. The old man humbly asked them for the ashes. Initially, they were angry with him, but later they allowed him to fill his basket with the ashes. Then he reached to his home. There was a withered tree in their garden. He sprinkled some of the ashes over it. Suddenly, it sprouted blossoms. It perfumed the air with its fragrance. The news of this reached the village. Then, the good old man heard about the arrival of the Daimyo. He climbed up an old withered cherry tree. In those days, at the arrival of the Daimyo, the villagers must bow down until the procession passed by to show their respect. Actually, there was a man to cry out, "Get down on your knees." When the Daimyo's palanquin reached near to the old man, he sprinkled a pinch of ashes over the withered tree. In a moment, it burst into blossoms. By this, the Daimyo became delighted and he ordered his people to be stopped there and walked out to see the wonder. He was really surprised and impressed by the old man. He called the man and thanked him. He ordered many rewards to be given to him. He also invited him to his castle. So, the old man went happily to his home and shared his joy with his dear wife. When the greedy neighbor heard about this, he also took some ashes and went on the highway to see the Daimyo. When the Daimyo's palanquin reached near to him, he took a handful of ashes and threw it over the withered tree. It did not blossom. The wind blew the fine dust in the noses and eyes of the Daimyo and his wife. They started sneezing. It spoiled the dignity of the procession. The man, whose business it was to cry, "Get down on your knees," seized him by the collar and dragged him from the tree. Then he beat him and left him for dead. Thus the wicked old man died in the mud. But the kind friend of the dog lived happily and prosperously. That's our story. So dear children, we should not be greedy. We should be kind towards all the creatures in the world. We have some textual activities related to this. Let's discuss it now. Page number 60. Comprehension check. Second one. Mark the right item. Here, three options are given for each question. We have to select the correct option. First one. The old farmer and his wife loved the dog. The answer B, option B, as if it was their own baby. Second one, when the old couple became rich, the answer is option C, lived comfortably and were generous towards their poor neighbors. Third question, the greedy couple borrowed the mill and the mortar to make, answer option C, a pile of gold. We have some textual activities related to question words. Questions that require information begin with question words. The question words are what, who, which, where, when, why, how, and whose. We use what to ask about actions, things, etc. Who to ask about people. Which to ask about people or things. Where to ask about place. When to ask about time. Why to ask about reason or purpose. How to ask about means, manner or degree. Whose to ask about positions. There are three activities related to question words. First one. Read the following paragraph and frame questions on the italicized phrases. Second one, write appropriate question words in the blank spaces in the following dialogue. Third one, fill in the blanks with the words given in the box. Try to do it. All the answers of these activities are attached in the notes. You can check it. Before that, you should do this. Page number 66, fourth one. Add im or in to each of the following words and use them in place of the italicized words in the sentences given below. The words given in the box are patient, proper, possible, sensitive, competent. First sentence, the italicized words are very difficult. Second sentence, lacks competence. Third sentence, lose patience. Fourth sentence, not a proper. Fifth sentence, without sensitivity. Do it yourself. Next, we have two activities related to articles. All of us know that there are three articles, a, an, and the. A and an are indefinite articles and the is the definite article. A is used before a singular countable noun. An is used before a word that begins with a vowel. The is used to speak about a particular person or thing or one already referred to. We will discuss this topic in detail later. Try to do it yourself. Page number 68, second one. Put each of the following in the correct order. Then use them appropriately to fill the blanks in the paragraph that follows. Use correct punctuation mark. Try to do it. The answer key of all these activities are attached with the notes. You can check it. Before that, you should do all these activities yourself. Next one. Are you fond of reading stories? Did you read one last month? If not, read one or two and then write a paragraph about the story. Use the following hints. Some hints are given. So dear children, utilize your holidays to read some books other than textbooks. It will help us to enrich our vocabulary. That's all for today. a YouTube URL is attached related to this lesson. Watch the video. The notes of this lesson is attached. Study it. A test paper is also included. Submit your answers as soon as possible. We can meet in the next class with a new topic. Till then, take care. Thank you.